When it came to signatures, I think of disclaimers, but I never thought about all of the other pieces that a signature should provide, whether it's marketing or just a consistent overall look to your company, a professional feel. And what happens is when you send an email from Outlook, you get the signature that you can attach, or if you send an email through Exchange or Exchange Online, you can create a sort of a signature that may work, but it doesn't work all the time. And the biggest thing that really caught my eye when it came to email signatures and Exclaimer specifically is that when you send an email from your mobile device, it should be the same signature as what you get when you're using Outlook. And I thought that makes sense, because how many emails do I send from my mobile now, or my iPad or something else, and it doesn't have an email signature attached at all? You know how sometimes you know that there's an easy way to do something, or you know there should be an easier way to do something, but you get lazy, and so you don't take the time to figure out how to do it? And I think that's what's kind of happening here, is that you know that you can do an exchange, you can do a transport rule and create a disclaimer, but that disclaimer, it's not pretty, right? And if you wanted to make it pretty, there's all sorts of extra things you can do and jump through a lot of hoops, but it's not consistent. It's not going to be as pretty as a third-party solution like Exclaimer can provide. And so you sit there and you go, oh, I don't like this, I don't like this, I don't like this. And that can go for months and months and months. I know I do that with things. I'm working in a certain way and I say to myself, this is not the most productive, this is not the prettiest, I don't like this, but I never make a move to change it. And maybe part of that is because I think that making that move is going to be too complicated. And if only I knew that, hey, there's a solution out there that I can just connect into and it's going to fix this problem, I would do it. It's better to, if you can give your people the ability, the people that actually have the ability to be graphics artists, they know what the look of your signature should be for your company from an advertising perspective, or from a, just an overall professional look perspective. If as an IT person, you can put a solution in place that you've put there, it works. And then you give it over to the people who are more graphics focused and say, here you go, it's nice and easy. You can preview it, it's gonna work, you just do it, and then you stick to what you're best at. Otherwise, when you're trying to do all of this in transport rules with HTML, and you're just mixing in too many things. It could become a real time hole. Well, it's funny, so I actually met Exclaimer last year at WPC 2015, and it was just like I was saying about education. It was a subject that I was not educated on. So it was one of those wow moments where I said, you know, I should know about this. I know that I've worked with other email signature solutions, but I never thought about it from the perspective of, like, for example, you folks have a connection with Azure, so that no matter where you're sending it from, whether it's Outlook, whether it's your mobile device, it doesn't matter. You know, it's all connected together so that you get the same unified email signature. I like that. I thought that was really cool. Yeah, I liked the way that you could build the signature in a graphic setting and then preview it. How is it going to look? You can't do that in Exchange, right? So I love that about the product. I love how you could control who gets what signatures, because, again, you can do that in Exchange using transport rules and applying that to different groups. But, again, you're building these, you know, multiple transport rules, and it's not easy to build the signature to the same level or degree. I mean, if you just want a one-liner disclaimer, you know, if you're not the intended recipient of this email, then, you know, don't read it. Then that's easy. Anybody can do that. But when you're talking about really doing up the signature nicely with the logos and all the images and all, that takes effort. And I think it came out really well. I think it really explains the situation and shows how Exclaimer fits right in terms of providing email signatures in the cloud for the cloud, which I think is great. You guys had a nice product, easy to use.